church.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship as we gather in God's house and online to be reminded that we are loved by God, we're saved through what Jesus does for us on the cross, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, we're called back out into the world to share God's love with everyone we come in contact with. Today is a special day for us at Living Waters as we turn the majority of the worship service over to the children of the church, who will be sharing with us the colors of Christmas based on this book from Matthew Paul Turner called All the Colors of Christmas. And so the kids will be telling us the story of Jesus' birth in Bethlehem and how we are all part of that storytelling. So kids of the church, are you excited to lead today? Are you excited to lead today? Are you excited to lead?
Yes!
I'm so glad. I'm so excited to hear you all tell the story. A few other things about our lived life together. You'll see in the bulletin information about our final midweek Vespers service on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. We've been focusing on three words: pause, prepare, and ponder. And Wednesday night, what we're going to do is during the reflection time, we're going to lift up prayers of all of the hard things that come this time of year. We sometimes gloss over that because it's what we're supposed to be full of joy, and our families are wonderful, and sometimes our families are hard, and life is hard. So our Wednesday service will be focusing on how it's kind of hard to be merry sometimes this time of year. So if you are in a place of struggle during the season, this might be a service that you want to put in your calendar. Next Sunday is Christmas Eve, and so we won't have service in the morning. We'll only have our Christmas Eve worship in the afternoon and evening. Two services at 4 o'clock and at 9 o'clock, both with communion and with candlelight. So we encourage you to come and bring your families, bring your neighbors. It's a wonderful time to be together. You would have received when you walked in with your bulletin on New Year's Eve day. It's also a Sunday, and so we'll be having, we started this last year, we're having a New Year's Eve worship brunch. And so what we'll do is we'll have worship in our chapel, and we'll be at tables having a meal together as we worship. And so if you're interested in participating in that, we'd love to know ahead of time. And it is a potluck. So if you would like more information about that, you can talk to either myself or Katie, and we'll fill you in on those details. With that being said, let us stand and begin with the lighting of the Advent. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, you are the hope in our messy world. Help us slow down, listen to your voice, and focus on what's really important. We place our hope in you as we prepare our hearts to celebrate your birth and Christmas. Amen. As we sing our song, we invite the children of the church to gather quarters as the Stafford family comes forward to light the candles.
Thank you.
congregation may be seated as I invite the children forward to help with the opening prayer.
You guys gotta stand up.
Thank you for our special son.
God, thank you for our special son.
Who came to show that you're the one.
Who came to show that you're the one.
He came to wash our sins away.
He came to wash our sins away.
So we can live in heaven someday.
So we can live in heaven someday.
Your gift of Jesus helped us see.
The gift of Jesus helped us see.
How much you love and care for me.
How much you love and care for me.
Do you think we should make the congregation do it with us?
Yes!
Okay. So Britta's going to say it, the kids are going to repeat it, and then the adults are going to repeat it. So you might want your bulletin.
God, thank you for our special son.
God, thank you for our special son.
God, thank you for our special son.
Who came to show that you're the one.
Who came to show that you're the one.
Who came to show that you're the one.
He came to wash our sins away.
He came to wash our sins away.
He came to wash our sins away.
So we can live in heaven someday.
So we can live in heaven someday.
So we can live in heaven someday.
Your gift of Jesus helps me see.
The gift of Jesus helps me see.
The gift of Jesus helps me see.
How much you love and care for me.
How much you love and care for me.
How much you love and care for me.
All right, lay back. Share the colors, and at the end of each color, we're inviting the congregation to respond. So be ready.
Trails, it's winter boots and puffy on suits. It's that old Mr. Green.
tongue-tied. It's tinsel on trees and grass iced by freeze. It's Christmas tree balls and artwork on walls. Yes, Christmas is green.
Yes, Christmas is green.
Thank you.
Our time of prayer. I'll end each petition with, Lord, in your mercy, and invite you to respond with, hear our prayer. With hope and expectation, we offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all who await God's day of restoration. Fill our mouths, O Lord, with laughter, and our tongues with shouts of joy as we bear witness to the great things you have done. Remind us what it looks like to live out our faith in childlike wonder and joy. Give your church a spirit of gladness as we gather and as we are sent out. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let the trees of the field sing of your praise. Protect forests, orchards, rainforests, and all wooded areas from disease and deforestation. Keep us grateful for their gifts of oxygen, food, shade, and shelter. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You love justice and promise your favor to those who are oppressed, brokenhearted, and incarcerated. Grant wisdom and compassion to those who work for public safety and all who work within prisons, jails, and courts, that mercy may increase and violence wither away. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us strength to pray for our world without ceasing, and move towards love and good deeds for all who are in need. Be with our friends and family, and with those in any kind of need. We ask you to be especially with Angela, Jackie, Oakland, Jim, Carol, Patty, Mark, Marilyn, Chris and Lana, Meg, Kate, Tammy, Heidi, Bennett, Chris, Kathy, Jackie, and Griffin. And we also include those in the quiets of our hearts at this time. Lord, provide for all who are without adequate housing, food, employment, or access to health care. Empower us as helpers and advocates. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
With gratitude, we rejoice in the saints who have witnessed to your life in all circumstances, in whom your spirit was not quenched, even in death. Through them, teach us always to hold fast to what is good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Listen to these prayers and all our prayers, O Lord, O God of hosts, and restore us with your great and everlasting mercy. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us share a sign of peace with one another.
Peace. Yourself.
congregation may be seated.
Kids have another song to sing.
We just had time for one verse. You can sing the rest of it in your head. I'd like you guys to sit here in the manger. We call this the manger because this is where baby Jesus was born. And I think it's time we hear the story. You've told us some amazing pieces about this story. So let me read it. Oh, thank you. You guys are so observant. Thank you for taking care of the pastor. All right. Ready? I'm going to tell the story. Here we go. At that time, everyone had to be counted so that they could pay taxes. Mary and Joseph had to go to Joseph's hometown of Bethlehem to be counted. Bethlehem is roughly 80 miles away from Nazareth where they were living. They had to walk in, and Mary was pregnant and was almost ready to have her baby. As they journeyed, she rode on a donkey because the traveling was long and hard and tiring. When they arrived at Bethlehem, the streets were crowded with people. There was no room for them anywhere, not in any inn. Joseph found a stable and Mary settled down in the straw. That night, baby Jesus was born in a stable. Mary rocked the baby in her arms and wrapped him in blankets and laid him in a manger of hay as the animals looked on. That same night, some shepherds were looking after their sheep in the fields. Suddenly, they were afraid. A crowd of singing angels appeared in the sky. Don't be afraid. We bring good news about Christ our Lord, the King of the Jews. You'll find him in a manger. The shepherds hurried to Bethlehem to see if it was true. And you know what? It was. They found baby Jesus lying in a manger. The shepherds thanked God and went to tell everyone their story. Far from Bethlehem, three wise men from the east saw a bright star in the night sky. The star was a sign a new king had been born. They followed the star to Bethlehem, where they found Jesus. And they bowed down and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Have you heard that story before?
Yeah, no.
It's a story we hear every Christmas because we're reminded that we are part of the story too, just like you all are part of the story. All right? Can you guys head back to your seats? We're reminded that the story of Jesus coming to us in the form of a small, vulnerable baby is a reminder to us of the fact that God comes to be with us in our mess, in our humanness, in all of life. And just as Jesus gathered his people together for that last meal, he gathers us once more. Holy, holy, great God of hosts, the earth is full of your glory. May we hear your call. May we know the assurance of your love, the equipping of your spirit, and your ever-present guidance and care. You call each of us into your ministry of forgiveness, into the body whose head is Christ, into a church family that stretches from coast to coast and around the world. Your love affirms our small efforts, forgives our sins, and shepherds us beside still waters. Your spirit equips and resources the church and enables gifts to emerge and blossom. Your continued guidance affirms risk-taking, creative action, and proactive initiative that sends us with your gospel message. Lead, challenge, and bless us, O Lord. May our lives be a collective voice of thanksgiving and praise to you, our rock and our salvation. In the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took bread. He blessed it and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death and resurrection until he comes once more. I invite able. As we join our voices and hearts together as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Congregation may be seated. At this time, I invite our communion servers forward to help make preparations for serving communion. I need to... Addie and Easton, will you come and hold baskets? Thank you. We'll be receiving communion this morning by coming forward. There will be two stations of bread, and then moving to either side to where the wine and grape juice are. The grape juice is the lighter colored liquid in the center of the trays. And then one step further overward, there will be baskets where you can put the cup. We also have gluten-free wafers available. If you are in need of that, just let those who are serving bread know. And all are welcome at this table.
That way. God's grace now and forever. Amen. The final part of the book. Christmas is you. It's your own unique hue. It's your wondrous gleam. It's your bedtime dreams. You color each Christmas anew. It's your tinsel and flair and the gifts that you share. It's your jingling smile and your fa-la-la style. It's how you love and care. It's the songs that you sing and the light that you bring. It's your heartfelt compassion and your hope put into action. It's your thrill for the little things. It's your love for what's true. It's the good that you do. You're a part of the story, the joy and the glory. Yes, Christmas is you.
Yes, Christmas is you.
Receive the blessing. A child is born. Alleluia.
Our God has come among us.
Let us leave the manger and return to our daily routines, knowing that we have seen the Lord and glorifying and praising God for all that we have heard and seen.
Alleluia. Our God is now here.
Go forth with good confidence and joy that you have in fact seen the Messiah.
Alleluia. Our God is now here.
Go forth and spread the good news wherever you go, sharing God's love and promise with all for whom you meet. Go into the world to find the lost, heal the broken, feed the hungry, release the prisoner, rebuild the nations, bring peace among people, and make music in every heart.
Alleluia. Our God is now here.
In the name of God, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit, we cry out with the angels in the heavens and the shepherds of the fields.
Alleluia. Our God is now here. Amen.
Let us stand as we sing our gathering song, and I invite the children of the church to meet me back at the baptismal font.
Yeah. Thank you.